Alright, now I've got all of my things opened up here. So, let's start by looking at my competitors for gourmet coffee. Sounds like fun, huh? And these, we're not really worried about them because they're not showing up in any kind of SEO. They're paid to be there. Same as all these guys on the right. So obviously we've got a really high advertiser. We've got advertisers everywhere, all over this stuff. So, gourmet coffee, and here's the Alexa traffic rank since I already installed their toolbar. It gives me what their traffic rank is, so I would highly suggest see Javalia. Their traffic rank is way up there. Baco Java. So, alright, so gourmet coffee. Obviously, they're going to be at the first one. It's in their domain name. Alright, then they have it in their first 20 words. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You know, all that, and they probably have it in the last 20 words. Same with here. They have it three times within the first 20 words. Gourmet coffee. Right. So they're going to show up both times, which they did, the first and second. So they've got this really nailed. All right. So gourmet coffee. Well, we already checked the traffic rank. But basically, what you would do is you'd come over here, go to their home page or whatever. Let's find home. Go to home. We're going to copy that. Then we're going to go over here to Alexa. And it's just alexa.com. I'll have all these links underneath the video when I'm done. That way you guys can just click on them and go. All right. Checking Alexa, see what they come up with, and see Alexa no data, which is fine. Doesn't mean that they're not getting traffic, it just means that Alexa doesn't know about it. So that's fine. We can always, you know, we check with their stuff. Alright, so now what I want to do, so you do that for all 10 of your all 10 of these search results right through here. Get to it. There we go. All 10 of these search results, you want to plug them into Alexa.com and see which ones are really showing up, or you can just install the Alexa toolbar by going here, toolbar right here, and click on that, and then you'll have this nifty thing, and on all of your searches, it'll automatically tell you, you know, if they've got decent traffic, no traffic, a little bit of traffic, you know, all that kind of stuff. It'll just automatically tell you that way. You don't even have to worry about coming over here unless you just want to get more detailed information. So now what we're going to do is we are going to plug these into Brad Collins SEO keyword generator, keyword cloud generator. I forget exactly what it's called. It's a really awesome program. Just looks like this, pretty plain, pretty easy. We're just gonna paste in our website right there, and I've already analyzed user-defined website or websites. All right, and you can always hit, you know, I think, what is it, Control Enter? Nope. I went ahead and started it. All right, so, and see, the age of a website matters a lot to Google and the search results. The older the website is, the more seniority it has, I guess you could put it. All right, and you want to be paying attention to their total links, total indexed. You know, how many pages are actually indexed? They have 279 pages indexed, all right? They've got a Google PR of 3, which is really good. Still, it's not the best, and it's, you know, it is beatable. So this means that somebody that's been here for 14 years really hasn't been doing their SEO as much as they should. They haven't really been paying attention to it, is what I would say. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and pause this, and we're going to come back as soon as all of this is done.
Alright everyone, this is Adam Pershbacher, and we've just concluded our keyword research tutorial. Now basically all you need to do is take your five key keywords that you've picked out and found out that, yeah, this niche is, I can break into it pretty easily, you know, they haven't done their SEO all that well, or, you know, whatever the reason, just take your five keywords and make a domain out of that. Like for me, I chose Rishi Gourmet Healthy Coffee because that includes everything that I need. That includes almost every single keyword that I decided that I wanted to rank for. So that'll help me with my SEO purposes quite well. So just take your list of five keywords and, you know, combine them in a way to where they're all being used only one time, only one word. You don't want healthy coffee, healthy beverages. That, I mean, you can, but it's not going to be wasting your time. You could go healthycoffeebeverages.com and be, you know, getting the same results. So, hope this helps, guys, and just stay tuned. I'll be bringing you more on SEO and, you know, internet marketing stuff so that you guys can stay tuned, and hopefully it'll help you guys grow your business larger than you thought possible yesterday. So, have fun, and I will talk to you guys later. Thanks. Bye.